Not that potato is bad, it can be made into like 100 million things, but sometimes I like to be a little French fry too, you know. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. So yeah, let's get started. So this is not like a no makeup makeup look, I'm not claiming it is. It's like a full face of makeup, and I do this makeup when I have to do shoots, when I have to take makeup shots. Like, this works really beautifully for me. I'll just pop on a few pictures here. Actually, when I posted these pictures is when a lot of you guys asked me to show you like how I did that makeup. If you want to see a no makeup makeup look or something, then I'll put it right here. You can click on this. So I prep my skin already, and if you want to see how I prep my skin, then again you can click here, you know, you can watch that video. So basically that's how I prep my skin in the morning, and before starting the makeup I like rejuice and re-moisturize. So I'm just going in back with my, again, Sugandha Aloe Tea Green Tea Gel. I'm going to use 2 pumps of that. I'm just going to rehydrate my face and re-moisturize, because I don't like, you know, want to have any dry patches on my face when I apply makeup. Next, it's extremely important to hydrate your eyes before you go in with makeup, because you apply a lot of concealer, a lot of powder. You don't want to dry your, you know, under eye out, and that's the most like sensitive area too. So I'm just going in with this Estee Lauder eye cream. You can just use your moisturizer too. I used to always use that, but since I have this now, I'm just applying this as an eye cream. So I'm like properly just hydrating the eye area before going in, like, you know, applying a lot of concealer and powder around that area. It's really important to do that, or else it's just like, you know, your eye, under eye is going to look extremely dry, which you don't want. And that's one of the reason why a lot of people complain that a concealer looks a little cakey as well, you know, because it starts getting really dry after all the concealer and powder, because they don't hydrate their eye. Because I have oily skin, I'm, you know, just going to set my face a little bit. So I'm going in with this Maybelline Fit Me powder, and I'm just going to take a tiny bit of it. I'm just going to apply it right like where my T-zone is. I don't even apply on the forehead, just like here and here. So a tiny bit, because that's where I sweat a lot, and this kind of helps me to diminish my pores as well. So if you want to see like properly how I do this, you can see my oily skin makeup. These are the videos I've already done, so it doesn't make sense for me to like re-explain again and again, because this would make a really long video. So I'm just going to take this sponge, and I'm just going to apply it right here. I'm using the Fit Me powder, so it has a little color, so it kind of even hides my, you know, pigmentation a little bit. Just on this area, it kind of, you know, sets it, and, you know, makes like my skin less oily throughout the day, and even like, you know, makes the pore disappear. So only right here, not like, you know, on the entire face, because I don't mind the shine like on the sides of the face. I mean, I don't get oily there. This is like the area where I should get supremely oily anyways. Next, I start off my base with contouring. So for contouring, I'm going in with this LA Girl concealer. This is in the shade Toast. You always want to make sure you apply it right here and blend it upwards. Don't place it too low. Now this is a lot of product. I usually don't apply so much like over a foundation, but you know, I'm applying this beneath the foundation, and I want it to be seen even after I apply the foundation. So I'm kind of going a little heavy-handed. If I'm going to go on with on top of the foundation, then I don't like apply so much. So for nose, I literally like, you know, like to bronze up the entire nose, a little on the jaw. Now the key is always to blend the product upwards. Don't drag the product downwards, or else, you know, your like face is just going to look muddy. So I'm just going to... So you can see, right, I'm just tapping and blending it up, tapping and blending it up. Like, you have to like be very gentle and like stroke the brush upwards and not downwards. And again, same for the jaw is like just tap and bring it a little down. Now again, for the forehead also, blend it inwards towards the hairline. You don't want there to be a weird line between your hairline and your forehead. So one more thing is, I do contour the perimeters of the, like, you know, what do you call this, ends of my eyebrow as well, because I like my face to look really narrow. If you're somebody who naturally has a very small face, then you must avoid that, so that, you know, your face doesn't like end up looking even more smaller. So, and that's it. I just like leave that nose a little like that only, like, you know, roughly blend it on the nose. I just leave it like that. Next, I'm taking this LA Girl concealer in medium beige and I'm just going to conceal my under eye with this. It's too much on this side, so I'm just scooping it and applying it on this side. I'm going in with a sponge now. I'm just using the Vichy sponge and I'm just going to blend that concealer out properly. So it just properly just concealed my face. Now you can see like I have a lot of dimension. The under eyes are concealer as well. Now I like literally need very less foundation. So for foundation, I'm going in with this Fit Me foundation in the shade 310. But before going in with the foundation, I'm just going to spritz my face a little with this MAC Prep and Prime. This just makes sure like if the concealer or anything is set, it kind of, you know, reactivates it. My dress doesn't want to stay in place. So just kind of reactivates it and, you know, it helps it to blend with the foundation a lot better. So I'm just going to add that right here. This is the area where I need a little coverage and the rest of the face is like pretty much okay. So I'm going in with the sponge and I'm blending this out. Now, one reason I like this sponge, like if you're a person who hates a sponge which absorbs a lot of product, then this is not for you. It does absorb a lot of product, but for me that kind of makes it a lot like better, because even if I go in with like a too much product, kind of absorbs anything, like most of the product, and gives me a very soft even layer. Now you need to make sure you use something which is medium coverage, not something full coverage, because you don't want to hide away the contouring you just did. So whatever is left on the sponge, I'm just going over that foundation, sorry, that contour with the sponge. Now first I just go and apply a very thin layer, then I just take a little more and I just apply on the areas where I think I need a little. So I'm just going to apply it right here where, like, you know, the spots have not been covered, because I did break out recently and the situation on my face is not good. So I'm just going to let that stay there for like a second before blending out. Maybe, you know what, let's just apply a little bit of concealer. So I'm just going in with this Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer in the shade Medium, and I'm just going to... Now the main key role is to highlight the inner corner. I know a lot of people kind of skip that inner portion, and that is what actually makes your eye like extremely like, you know, awake and bright. You always have to like, you know, highlight that inner portion. So, you know, you cannot do that once again you apply like your concealer, set the powder. When you go in with eyeshadow, it's quite a little difficult for you to, you know, go with that step, because like, I mean, the powder messes with the concealer. So you need to make sure you get into that area really well. Like, you can see any of my videos on Instagram, I always go in that corner like before like I get into the eyeshadow, because it gives me a lot easier, you know, space to work with. Now I applied way too much concealer talking to you guys, because I don't need so much since I already highlighted underneath. But I just applied it, so we kind of have to, you know, work with this. I'm just blending out this. So now for concealer, what you're supposed to do, and I know a lot of people do this mistake, is like, let's see, like this is my hand right now, right? So they go with a sponge and they like, you know, just blend it like this. I mean, this does blend it, but it's not going to concentrate the part where it's supposed to. So what you're supposed to do is take the sponge and concentrate it first there, like this is like where the product is, right? So let's just like notice what I'm doing. Maybe I'll take a cleaner sponge. So I'm just going to make sure your sponge is damp. So it's not like wet, it is just damp. I run it under the water and I squeeze out all the, you know, excess water, and that's like a damp sponge. So now see how I'm doing. I'm just going to take the sponge and bounce it on the under eye. So I'm bouncing it, concentrating in that area for like literally like more than 2-3 seconds. You can see I'm just still in the same area. I just like didn't do this and then, you know, go here. So I'm concentrating in the starting, like in the inner portion, because that's where I need the maximum, like highlighted and brightened look. So I'm going to concentrate my concealer there more. Now, like I told you, I did apply a lot of product, like talking to you guys. Usually I don't apply so much. So, you know, a little goes a long way. So sometimes if you do the mistake I did and you went like with a lot of product, then take the cleaner side of the sponge and go around that, like, you know, concealer. It kind of picks off the excess product and gives you a more, like, you know, lesser product for you to blend. Now always blend the ends of the foundation and concealer as well. So basically this is where the concealer is ending. You need to make sure you blend that starting and ending point of the foundation in the contour and concealer, because you don't want a harsh line where the concealer is ending and where the contour is starting. So for my nose, what I'm going to do is, remember I used the sponge to blend my contour, right? So I'm just going to use that same brush and I'm just going to go around the nose and like blend it. So it has that leftover product of the contour on the brush. So it kind of mix that concealer and the, you know, contour together. So it just looks a little more natural. So next for powder, I'm going in with this Laura Mercier translucent powder and I'm just going to set my under eyes with it. Now make sure there is no creasing. And now take the powder and push it into your line, guys. Get the powder into your lines and that is when the concealer won't crease. So by God's grace, I still don't have smile lines. Maybe I will get it in the future, but now currently I don't have it. So like I don't really like crease around my mouth a lot, but I still do set my, like, you know, mouth area really well, because that's like a place where there's a lot of movement. Like I constantly talk, smile, eat and all those things. And if you have smile lines, it's kind of like inevitable to avoid, because I don't know, it's, you know, under eye creasing can be prevented, but like smile lines is like literally impossible, you know, to completely like be creaseless. It's not possible. Okay, so basically I just set around the under eye and like around the, you know, nose and around the mouth, and the rest I just like, you know, kind of like take a very fluffy brush and I just like randomly just touch a little bit here and there and set it, because that's not the area where I get really oily or I crease or anything of that sort. Next for contour, I'm using this KKW Beauty powder. This is one of my favorite contour powder. I apply a lot of contour, just, you know, gives a lot of dimension. So you can see there's already a shadow going on right there, but it's extremely soft because we applied foundation on it. So usually what happens is like when somebody turns on the right and like, you know, you can literally see like there's a harsh line there. We don't have that. It's extremely soft and like, you know, really neat. So now I'm just going in with the fluffier brush and I'm just going to add and tap a little bit of contour on the same area. I'm just going to bring it till right here and I stop it right here and a little into the forehead. I have a really huge forehead, so I kind of like contour the entire forehead so that I want to hide it away, and I just like bring it till here. Now for nose, I literally contour my entire, like bronze up my entire nose. Kind of adds a lot of, you know, what do you say, color to the nose. And it gives like, you know, there is a nose, but it's not too large, it's not too small. It is there. It is there and it gives a little color to the face rather than just being like a spot of like a potato there. So that's it for like the contouring part. Next is the blush. This is the Kylie Cosmetics blush. So I'm just taking and dusting that excess off. And I'm just like, see, now when you want to lift your features, you're supposed to apply it like on the highest points. So from here to here, your blush would kind of blend into the contour, give you a lot of color. But if you want a very flush of color, like, you know, bubbly round face, then you can kind of apply it right like on the cheeks as well. I like, you know, looking very cheeky. I have naturally, like, you know, a chubby face because I am a chubby girl. So I'm just going to blend that into Now, blush is something I apply a lot, and a lot of people tell me also that I apply a lot. But what happens is, guys, blush, the first thing which disappears, like the first thing to fade away from your makeup is a blush. So it's always good to apply more, because it kind of like literally blush stays away. Like this intensity of the blush might hardly stay for half an hour to 1 hour, and then it dims down and it looks appropriate. So I do go in a little bit heavy with the, you know, blush, because it kind of dims down over time. Really pretty. I'm so happy. I'm doing makeup after so long. Feels really good. Next, let's move on to the eyes, and then we'll come back to our highlighter and the rest of the makeup. So basically, the way you contour your face like matters so much. I'll pop the picture here before makeup. You can see like the under eyes are a little darker, my cheeks are a little lighter, and there's like no dimension. Like the ideal dimension which we achieve when we are doing makeup is like, you know, bright under eyes, chiseled cheeks, and literally my natural face is quite opposite to that. So you know, all these features, like when you pop the features which you require and which you want to pop, kind of the whole dimension of your face changes. Like once I highlight my under eyes, the like the rest of the face is covered. So like, you know, my eyes are the main focus and a lot of attention is grabbed here, and the rest is like hidden away. So for contouring, I kind of like literally create this heart shape kind of look, and that's ideal. Like anybody these days want to get that. But one thing I avoid always, and which I see a lot of people doing and which doesn't suit me at all, is to bake right here. Now ideally people, you know, want to get that more snatched chiseled contour, so they kind of take the, you know, baking powder or something and kind of bake that area so that, you know, that contour is popped a lot more. For me personally, what happens is like I'm a very chubby person and I want to hide that, like I don't want to hide it, but when I'm giving the dimension, I want a lot of high cheekbones and everything. But once I highlight this area, this literally I have is like, you know, this is fat, like this is my chubby cheek fat, and this get enhances, which I don't want. So like once this get enhanced, like the entire work which I did on my face like doesn't make sense, because like these start popping out and my jaw looks really big. And so that's one thing I completely avoid, that I don't like it. I used to do it, but like later I realized that it doesn't suit me at all and I stopped doing it. So next, let's move on to brow. Now these days there's a lot of trend of bushy brow, and it is good, but I feel sometimes a lot of people go overboard with like a bushy brow. I mean, if I kind of draw a little extra also, my like brows become like poof, like too much, like they conquer my entire face. So you need to always make sure you do your brows according to your face shape. Like not because somebody has like thick bushy brows doesn't mean it suits you as well. A lot of people look extremely beautiful with skinny brow, and it is there's nothing wrong with it. You can make it like more feathery when it is thin as well. So be mindful. I do see a lot of people like, you know, literally like their eyebrows like occupy their entire face. If they, you know, they thread it, remove it a little bit, tweeze it here and there. You can play a lot with your eyebrows, guys. And if you don't have eyebrows, so you can play like even more. Now, one thing which changed my look completely is back in the day, like when I was 8th standard, until like even not 8th standard, until my engineering first year also. So my brows used to start right here and they used to end right here. Like, you know, I used to have that, what do you call that, arc brow, arrow brow, something like, a lot of people had obsession with that, such a long elongated brow back in the day. So I also wanted it, and that's how I did it like for years and years and years. But what I realized, like one day I just like decided to chop that off and see. So ideally, like when you highlight your under area also, you kind of get that brightening effect from here, and you lift it like in the end, and like basically you want to lift this eye. So from the lower lash line, you lift that brightness of the under eye as well. So that time what I did is I kind of matched my lower lash line with the brow as well. So basically my brow ends exactly where my, you know, lower lash line inclines, like the line wherever the lower lash line. So when I highlight this area, my like literally the entire eye portion is very lifted and looks really beautiful. I tried thin brows, I tried bushy brows, but this is like the ideal shape which suits my brow. So what I do for my brows is I just fill the, like, you know, starting portion, because this is like where I don't have like evenness. So I just like fill a little bit and leave it, that's it. So this brow is like very nice, but this brow for me is very problematic. I do have like a chicken pox thing right here, so I don't really have hair below it like I have right here. So I kind of have to fill this and try to even these two out a little. always work in strokes. Don't like, you know, create harsh lines. So I'm just going to like fill that center even more. So that's it, guys. Like, literally, that is what I do for my brows. I don't overdraw. But one thing I always do, and I recommend a lot of people doing, is carving your brow. But you need to be like careful, you don't destroy the shape of the brow. So I'm going in with the same concealer, the Maybelline, and I'm just taking a very flat brush and I'm coating the concealer. So I just take that flat brush and I push the product down like this, and then it, so that, you know, it's just easier to blend later, like when I'm normally applying the concealer like right here. So I'm just taking that, adding a little on the lid as well, and I'm just coating that concealer on the entire lid. So these are the things I do, because on camera, like when you're taking pictures, and especially when you're taking portrait, this like looks beautiful, like beautiful. It just enhances your features so much, gives that right amount of light. So when you take, you know, makeup photos, you need to be very, very sure of how you place the makeup, because like the light is supposed to hit on the proper area. So like I want the light to hit right here. So this is where I highlighted. I want the light to not like, you know, highlight this portion. So that's where I contour. So you need to be very, very precise when you take makeup shots. The little things you do in makeup only make like a huge difference in how your entire, you know, face looks. Now I did blend that out here, so it kind of got a little lighter on this side. So I'm just going in with the same bronzer brush. Doesn't have anything, so I'm just going to like lightly touch up there to get back that warm. Ideally, if I go in with like, you know, proper eyeshadow, then I don't set the concealer. But now I'm not going to do extreme glam, so I'm going in with the powder and properly setting the, you know, eyelids. Now I did highlight this portion, but there's one thing I do is I, you know, get the brow and the nose contour to mix properly. So I'm just like, you know, doing that, just taking a very fluffy brush. Next, I'm just taking this Wet n Wild contour powder. You can use the same bronzer you use, but this is like extremely medium pigmented. So I like to go in with this on the eye, so it's just like not so harsh. So I'm going in with that same fluffier brush and I'm just going to add this in my crease area. And I'm just going to kind of like, you know, what do you say, bronze that up a little bit. I'm going to drag that a little out as well. And then I'm taking the same bronzer on like, you know, angle brush, and I'm going to lightly give a slight wing. It's a very you cannot even see it. If you want that to be seen, then you can go with a brighter color. Now I want it to be like very minimal, like it just gives me a lot of definition which is not like visible to the like normal eye. So I just like kind of use that and I wing that outer portion. And with the same product again, I go in with the lower lash line as well. All these things just, you know, gets back the definition to the eye. So I'm just going to bronze up the under eye. I always just stop it right here, like, you know, after 3/4 of the thing, because if I highlight, you know, if I bronze it up till here, then kind of makes it more rounded. But if it's highlighted and then bronze, it kind of, you know, lifts the eye as well. So I just like end it right here. Now, if I'm not going to apply like false lashes or anything, then I leave it like right here. But if I'm going to apply false lashes, then I do like to line my, you know, lid a little bit. So this is the Huda Beauty Rose Gold palette. So I'm just going to take this, like, you know, mix a little black and a little brown. I'm going to like very, very closely line the lid. Like, you won't be able to see this once you apply the false lashes. So usually if you don't do this, there's going to be a little space seen between the lash and the, you know, lid. There's going to be a little white skin type of thing peeping through. So if you do this, it's going to give that proper like neat look of the lash. So next I'm just going to curl my lashes, apply mascara, and I'll be right back. Oof, you guys, I don't know how people take like, you know, 2 minutes to apply lashes. For me, it at least takes 5 to 10 minutes. Some days they apply really quickly and some days it's like too much. So anyway, these are the pack 53. I love these lashes. They are like, they're not natural, but they can be natural. And the best thing is, like, you cannot see that you applied false lashes, so they kind of look like lash extensions. You can kind of get away with them looking a little like normal, your natural lashes as well. So look really pretty, they're not over the top. So next, let's move on to highlighter. And before highlighter, you know the drill, I have to set my face. So for setting spray, I'm just using this Morphe settings, kind of running out of this as well. The Balm cosmetic, it's broken, guys. I cannot show you, it's broken. First, before that, I don't want like the, any excess setting powder on the face. So I'm going to just dab away a little on the cheek area. And I'm just going to take a tiny bit. I'm dabbing the excess off my hand as well, so that there's no like too much product. And I'm just going to add it on the high points. Now, I do get it down to the cheek, because when I smile, it looks on good on the cheek. But I do have a little bit of, you know, bumps going on right there. So it kind of will get exaggerated. It already did by the time I'm talking. So, you know, if you don't want something to be seen, then you have to keep it matte. Now I highlight a little like on the forehead arch a little, so that, you know, when I look like this, it grabs attention. And that's it. I blend it really well. Now the main hero of our highlight game is our inner corner highlight. So I'm just going to take that again and apply it on the top. So I always apply and highlight the top part of the lid. So I just go in like this and I highlight the upper part, like the inner corner on the top. And I don't, like, you know, round off and highlight the lower part, because I feel that kind of gets me a lot of unwanted attention. Like if I put it right here, my kind of eye bags start popping a lot. I don't know, because that gets highlighted, so it kind of looks really weird. So I just, you know, highlight on the inner corner, but on a top part, so kind of, you know, looks a little awake and lifted. And that's it. Maybe a little, like, you know, downward, so that there's no like harsh line, but concentrating it a lot on the like top part, like instantly, right? Like so much difference. I love inner corner highlight, just gives so much attention to the eyes. So for the nose, what I do is I just highlight the, what you call, the top part. So I'm just taking the same brush, but I'm going to use it like this now, like the straight part. So I'm just going to take a tiny bit and I'm going to like start off right here. So this is where I'm going to highlight. I'm going to tone it down a little bit. A little more tiny bit, and add it right in the center. Like, I don't want to be at like a big dot. You should be very, very precise, or else again, it like little look like you have really big nose bulb. So I'm just taking a tiny bit and I apply it right here. Kind of you know, elongates and gives a lot of attention to the nose. That's it. Like, you see, right? Only that much. And clean off whatever is on the brush, and then you can kind of blend it properly. Don't want, like, you know, too rounded tip. And if you think it's a little extra, then you can go ahead with that bronzer and tone it down a little as well. And you know, for lips, basically for most lips, I'm a pink girl. Pink nudes are my go-to thing. I don't like corals, I don't like oranges. It is like, I need a time and a place and like an eye look for me to wear those, but if not, I'm always a pink girl. So for lips, I'm just going to line my lips with this Wet n Wild lip liner in Berry Red. So for my lips, what I do is, like, if I don't know if you can tell, this side of my lip is smaller compared to this side of the lip. So I only, like, you know, what do you say, shape the right side of my lip. If you want to know that if one lip is smaller or not, you can click a picture and see. That's how I realize that I have it, because I click a lot of pictures, see myself in a video, and if I just follow the natural line, this lip always looked smaller than the other side. So only, not like, I don't line the entire lip, only this is the area where it is like smaller. So this is the only like part where I like overline the lip. So this, I just like naturally followed the line of the lip and I'm just filling it in. Now again, naturally followed it till here, but now I'm going to elongate more on the outer side. So it kind of equalizes it both, but without like looking too much. And I even, like, you know, joined the Cupid's bow, and I kind of I don't let that, like, you know, V stay. I kind of little bit, like not too much, I round it off a little bit. Now, next I'm just going to use this Sephora liquid lipstick in the shade 82. I like how it looks, but I think it's a little bright. So I'm just going to go in with this Too Faced Melted Matte in the shade Sellout. I'm just going to add that in the center. Then finish it off with the setting spray again. There's actually just one little mistake I did. So the shadow on the nose, like with the highlight which I added it little to the right, and it looks little, you know, crooked on the right side. So I'm just going to take the bronzer back and I'm going to remove that shine and that highlight on the right side and pull it more towards the center. So yeah guys, that is it. That is the finished look. I love the way this looks in pictures. I love the way this looks in real life. It just enhances my features really, really well. I love like this look. I hope you guys liked and learned something out of the video. And if you did, then make sure you like, share and subscribe to my channel. And ring the notification bell and make sure you comment and tell me if you love this look or not. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.